Here we are, Mark and Howard, about to do another walking adventure. This time we are in the Yorkshire Dales and we are walking the Three Peaks, starting with Ingleborough. And tomorrow we will tackle Whernside, and then on the third day we will do Penny Ghent. Now normally people do a challenge and they'll do them all in one go and take up to 20 hours, that sort of thing. But we're going to do one a day, and we're not doing a complete circuit. We are going to just come to each peak and walk around it. So we're doing on average about 7 miles a day on average, which we are looking forward to immensely. Now we're staying in Settle. We're based in Settle for that time, and it's only a short drive to each peak, so it's an ideal place to stay. And we are looking forward to this immensely. At the moment, we've just arrived in a delightful village, what we've seen already, called Clapham.
Here we are, we're setting off. We're not quite sure if we're going the right way. Excuse me, is there a church up this way?
Yes, there is.
Oh.
Just around here.
Lovely, thank you for that. Yeah, so it looks like we're going in the right direction, which is always a good start, isn't it?
To any walking holiday.
Always make sure you're going in the right direction.
So, Ingleborough Peak, here we come. And starting off in Clapham, we have to conclude, what a lovely place. What an absolutely lovely place. Isn't it, Howard?
It's a really lovely place.
What would you say about this place?
Well, it's a lovely place.
It's a lovely place. Do you know what I think?
What do you think?
Clapham is a lovely place. Oh, it's a lovely place. Here we are then, walking in stunning countryside. We're selfieing at the moment, and I've got my baby by the arm, and it's great.
We love walking, don't we?
With each other, yeah.
Yeah.
It's great, perfect.
We
do. To be in the countryside is just amazing.
Is it our favourite thing, walking
together? It is, yeah, and eating.
Oh, walking, yeah, we like eating, don't we?
Yeah. I feel so good. That's the thing about walking, is that you just get away. You get away.
This is just something that, I don't know, forest creatures have created for their fairy king.
Who are you in that hierarchy?
Fairy King.
All hail the Fairy King. All hail the Fairy King. Hail the Fairy King.
I'd like robes. Deep velvet robes. And I'd like to sit here and check people have paid. There's some people behind us that, you know, that we said we had to pay 65p. They said, oh, we'll pay it on the way down. Of course they don't. How do you think that things like this, like Ingleborough Cave, are preserved if you don't pay?
Right, I want you to be your fairy king, and I'll be one of those people, and I want you to stop and ask me if I paid.
Okay.
Go.
Halt! Who goes there?
I'm just a lone traveller, sir.
Your ticket, sir.
Who are you, sir?
The Fairy King, sir.
How much do you want from me, sir?
65p for an adult, 35p for a child.
And if I haven't got it?
Well, back to the car. God, I've turned into the Queen.
You're the Fairy Queen, aren't you? You're not the Fairy King at all. You
are the Fairy Queen.
You're the Fairy Queen! There you are! You've been rumbled!
Feel better now, you fairy queen?
Onwards and upwards.
It's really nice now. We're at the probably the top of what we think is Little Ingleborough. The sun's come out, the wind has dropped. We're warmer because we've been walking uphill. And the scenery as you come up this high is really stunning. Really stunning, isn't it? Isn't it?
Well, we're down, and there's not a lot of fun to be had because we both feel quite broken. It was an odyssey in that wind, and exhausting, really. And one down, blooming two more to go. And there we go. We need to get back and have a nice hot shower, a nice bottle of wine, some food. We're a miserable pair of who've had enough today. We've had enough. We've had enough.
It's all you've got to say.
All I've got to say. Hello, good morning. So here we are at Ribblehead Viaduct.
The Ribblehead Viaduct is a masterpiece of Victorian construction.
And that is at the bottom of Whernside, the second of the three peaks we're tackling.
I don't think I can.
The weather is lousy. As you can see, we're dressed like a couple of wallies. But we arrived here, got out the car, screamed like a couple of girls, and then drove 12 miles back to settle to find a shop that sold some trousers that would take away the chill. So we've got these little bad boys on.
What size are your trousers?
My trousers are extra small, men's, and Howard's are size 10 women's to accommodate his childbearing hips.
How's the visibility?
Well, Howard, it is very low. It is low vis. We're calling it Velo Viz. And although it's Velo Viz, you can still see the beauty of these fells.
I'd climb the highest mountain if I knew that when I climbed that mountain, I'd find. I'd swim.
We've just met two people and we asked how long it was to the top of Whernside, and they reckon it's about an hour and a half, 2 hours, but I have a feeling that they were going pretty fast. They said that there's really, really low visibility up there. What was it, something like 10 foot? And really, really windy. So that's something to look forward to.
You know Velo Viz. She's the sister of Lilo Lil.
Means nothing to me, no matter where you are. That's where I want to be. I bring
Whernside, 1.75 miles.
Cause I know that if
it's very misty, we can't see very much at all. The saving grace is the fact that there's a path which seems to be going all the way up, which means that we don't have to worry too much about not being able to see. But yeah, it's getting quite steep now.
Honey child, I'd climb the highest mountain. That is, if I knew when I got to the top that I'd find you sitting there. I'd even swim the deepest river if I knew that when I swam
made
river,
it
you'd be waiting.
I'm sounding like I had a jab from the dentist because my face is so numb on this side. Visibility is V poor viz. We've come all the way up and we can't see anything at all. But we've made it, and now the only thing we've got to do is find our way down.
That's just where I want.
I'll tell you something. They call this the Three Peaks Challenge in this weather it blooming well is. Blimey.
Cause I know that if I got to heaven, I'd find you.
I've twisted my knee. Well, in a matter of seconds, the sun has come out. It started warming my face. We're on our way down now, the other side. And there's a view. And that's what we came here for, but we're now down a bit. You can actually see the top now. So that, well, that was nice and welcome and so very surprising. And in the distance, of course, you can see the viaduct. Well, here we are then, in the station inn, with a pint of ale and a pork pie. Having finished the second of the peaks, Whernside. Very challenging like yesterday, but you feel good after you've done it, so mission accomplished.